On December 5th, 1965, the aircraft carrier USS Ticonderoga was traveling about 70 miles off the coast of Okinawa, Japan. During a training exercise, an A-4E Skyhawk loaded with a 1 megaton B-43 nuclear bomb rolled off the deck. The aircraft, pilot, and live bomb were lost in 16,000 feet of ocean. Ships searched for hours after the accident, but no trace of the plane or the thermonuclear bomb it carried were ever found. This accident was kept a secret for more than 20 years, but this isn't the only time the US has had a problem with nuclear payloads. The launch of Sputnik 1 by the Soviets in 1957 cemented the Soviets' dominance in the space race for most of the next decade. The Soviets could now launch an attack on US soil in only 30 minutes, so fast that American bombers might not be able to even get off their runways. That launched America's response, Operation Chrome Dome, a mission that for nearly a decade would see at least a dozen B-52s flying 24/7 along the Soviet borders and around the world, ready to counterattack should the Soviets fire a missile. With nuclear bombers flying around the clock, air crews would have to stay airborne for 24 hours straight, refueled in the air. All this meant there were bound to be a few accidents. Today, the Department of Defense has admitted that between 1950 and now, there have been 32 broken arrow accidents, with 6 nuclear weapons lost that were never recovered. Here are a few of the other times the US has had a serious nuclear mishap. On March 10, 1956, a B-47 carrying 2 nuclear weapon cores from MacDill Air Force Base in Florida to an overseas airbase disappeared during a scheduled air-to-air refueling over the Mediterranean Sea. After becoming lost in thick clouds at 14,000 feet, the plane was never heard from again, and its wreckage, including the nuclear cores, were never found. The exact weapons aboard remain classified, but they're believed to be Mark 15s with payloads of 2.4 megatons each. That's 250 times the destructive power of the Hiroshima bombs, and if detonated, would have left substantial nuclear fallout across most of the Mediterranean. On January 24, 1961, a B-52 carrying 2 nuclear bombs crashed while trying to land at an airbase near Goldsboro, North Carolina. The 2 3-4 megaton Mark 39 thermonuclear bombs were jettisoned midair to keep them away from the exploding aircraft. One of the bomb's parachutes opened, slowing its fall, but the other hit the ground at 700 miles per hour, burying itself deep in the muddy soil of the Nahunta Swamp. Each of the M39 bombs were equipped with 4 interlocking safety mechanisms, all of which had to be triggered to explode the bomb. On the bomb that landed intact, 3 of the safety mechanisms had been activated during the fall. Only a single switch prevented the bomb from detonating. Had it detonated, everything in an 8.5 mile radius, including the town of Goldsboro, would have been instantly vaporized. And the other bomb that hit the ground, despite leaving a massive crater, had dug itself so deep into the swamp, it could never be recovered. So the Air Force has just left it there to this day. On May 22, 1957, a B-36 bomber was transporting a Mark 17 nuclear bomb from Briggs Airfield in Texas to Kirtland Air Force Base, just miles south of Albuquerque, when suddenly the bomb fell through the bay doors. Accounts from the crew of what caused the accidents vary, but one version says that a crew member in the bomb bay was being thrown around by sudden turbulence. Trying to steady himself, he accidentally grabbed the manual bomb release lever, causing the weapon to fall through the bay doors and plummet to the earth. The bomb fell 1,700 feet and exploded as it crashed in a nearby field. The bomb's conventional explosives detonated, creating a huge crater, but the nuclear capsule didn't detonate and was found intact. The only casualty? A cow who had been grazing nearby. Technically, the only US casualty ever recorded from a nuclear bomb. This particular bomb was estimated to have been the most powerful bomb the US ever made at 10 megatons. If the nuclear capsule had detonated, the bomb would have had an explosive force about 625 times that of the Hiroshima bomb and killed 500,000 US citizens. And also that cow. On May 22, 1968, while returning to its home base in Norfolk, Virginia, the nuclear attack submarine USS Scorpion mysteriously sank about 400 miles southwest of the Azores Island. To date, the Scorpion is one of only 2 US nuclear submarines to have ever been lost, and was one of 4 mysterious submarine disappearances in 1968. In addition to the loss of all 99 crew members, the Scorpion was carrying 2 250 kiloton torpedoes tipped with nuclear warheads. Those warheads were never recovered. Next up, you'd think it would be pretty hard for a bomber carrying no nukes to cause a nuclear accident. Well, on July 27, 1956, after a training mission, a B-47 bomber made a difficult landing at Lakenheath Royal Air Force Base near Suffolk, England. The plane skidded out of control and slid off the runway, hitting a nuclear weapons storage facility containing three Mark VI nuclear bombs. Each bomb had about 8,000 pounds of TNT as part of its trigger mechanism. Luckily, the blazing jet fuel did not ignite the TNT, and the fire was extinguished by the base firefighters. But the crew of the B-47 were killed, and all three bombs were damaged to the point they had to be shipped back to the US to be fixed. Investigators thought it was a miracle that the bombs didn't explode. These broken air accidents and missing nukes are just the tip of the iceberg. But it's not just the US. The Soviets have had their fair share of broken arrows, including the sinking of a Soviet Yankee 1-class nuclear submarine that carried a whopping 34 nuclear weapons aboard. The missiles were never recovered, and the wreckage site is publicly known. No new broken arrows have been reported for more than 40 years, so either the US got a lot better at handling their nukes, or a lot better at covering up their accidents. If you're thinking about trying to recover one of these lost nuclear bombs, don't bother. You can learn how to make your own with this video here. And remember, there is always more to learn.